Dear folks, Earth as a planet, it's a beautiful planet. Lot of living beings are there. In sea kingdom, we find fishes. In the air kingdom, we find birds. And in the animal kingdom, we find lion, tiger, elephant, whatnot, thousands. But in the land, human being, he is also there. So every one of them produce their offsprings. To maintain the ecology, to maintain the balance, to carry on the hereditary characters. So we have come from the caveman life to now how modern civilized we are. So each offspring generations, as they keep coming, they become more polished, they become more scientific. So here only man has the control, man as a human being, only he has the control to reduce and expand his population. He destroys the population through war. He destroys the population through pollution. He destroys or stops the population by his own way. We find two different continents, or two different world, if you divide. One is eastern side and one is western side. In eastern side, we see high population. Indians having high population, Pakistanis and Chinese. The other side, you find European countries where they don't have much population. One Sweden and Switzerland, one US and UK, you find the population is very less. So most of the population from the developed countries go to the developed countries to help them. So here we are going to an important topic here. Legalization of abortion in India, is it justified? See page number 217 and 219. The family planning programs is being conducted throughout India with full involvement. The people who support reducing population welcome legislation of abortion as an important step in the correct direction. 1975, when emergency was introduced in India, Sanjay Gandhi, the son of late Indira Gandhi, and Sanjay Gandhi also expired due to the plane crash. They implemented the strict family planning program in India because of the high population. It was quite successful, but it went against the people's wishes. They were forced. If you have two child, they will take you and do vasectomy for males, so that they won't be able to produce children for males. For females also, if you are having more than two child, you can go to a hospital and do family planning program, and they were rewarded. You were given a rise, you were given special concessions. And we also see some of the ministers having 13 children. Even after the laws legislated, you know who is the minister is? Let me not say. 13 children. He was the chief minister, his wife was also a chief minister. So here, abortion, this is a delicate subject. It brings moral, emotional and sentimental effects on society. The people are permitted to abort only when the specific circumstances and reasons. For example, if a lady is very weak to give birth to a child and if it may result in her death, abortion is permitted on medical grounds. A girl is born twice. Once when she is born. Later, second is when she gives birth to a child, she is born once again. So people were anxiously waiting earlier days. When she becomes pregnant, when she is going to deliver child, is the mother and child safe? Usually it was like either mother dies or the child dies. But now the time has changed. Abortion is a boon to most of the families in India. Number third, appreciating the cause of abortion as a part of family planning is wrong. You are going against the topic. A rich country like India with great resources should not be bothered about the high population. See, India, it is something unique. India, something great. Columbus, when he wants to, he was very eager to find out where India is. So wrongly, he landed up to America. And he started the people living there, started to name the people who are living there as Indians. That's what the name came, Red Indian. Then after, once again he came and came to India, that is different. Vasco da Gama, everybody want to know about India. India has very rich resources. Not like Australia, only 90% of land is usable. not like China, only 75%, I mean only 25% of land is usable. In Australia, 90% of land is non-usable. India, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, it is very cultivable land. Lot of rivers are running. A rich country like India with great resources should not be bothered about the high population. India has a very vast resources. At least now India has been divided into Bangladesh and Pakistan. Before, unified India, it's a very rich country. Much richer than America. It was richer than European countries. Civilizations were strong. From top to bottom, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India was rich. It's fertile land. In Australia, only 10% of land is cultivable. In China, only 25% of land is cultivable. But India, 80% of land is cultivable, other than that desert area. So, here, the gender can be identified only when the fetus is 3 months old. Only when the mother is 3 months old. I mean, the fetus is 3 months old in the mother's womb. They can identify whether the child is a girl or a boy. After the doing abortion, it spoils the health of the mother. It's a risk for her life. So, the fourth point is here. And the fifth point, even though abortions help to control the population, abortion weakens the women and reduces her lifespan. It says a girl is born twice, once she is born and second when she gives a delivery, when she delivers a child. Earlier, whenever the mother gives a birth to a child, people were anxiously waiting. There are chances of either mother surviving or the child surviving or both dying. But nowadays, cesarean operations, nowadays we find 100% safety, that is infant, the mortality rate is good. Many duplicate doctors play with the life of women by saying they are abortion specialists. To reduce the abortion rate, the government had introduced number of contraceptive measures which can prevent pregnancy during the time of emergency. First time in India, the compulsory contraceptive methods which were forced on the people by Sanjay Gandhi. It was successful, but it was forced upon the people. Many teenagers, especially in village, live their life during the process of abortion. So, in village, lose their life during the process of abortion. We don't have the right to kill the lives of others and make our life also in danger. Globalization and change in lifestyle made men and women to come closely. Ford, one BMW, one Microsoft, one IBM, hundreds of MNC companies, hundreds of American companies, European companies, Australian companies, Korean companies, Taiwanese, they come to India, Chinese companies, they come to India. The globalization, the cosmopolitan culture, which made men and women to come closer, which resulted in unwed mothers. So, to avoid humiliations, but society, we still follow certain rules and regulations. It is considered to be a humiliation. So, abortion helps for the women to save their dignity, their status. We should live like our forefathers. The kings and queens were having a lot of children. In Mahabharata, Dasaratha was having 100 children. They never went against nature. So, the idea of abortion is wrong. The abortion should be legalized only for unwed mothers, but they should not kill the fetus on the basis of gender. If it is a female, kill the child. No, it is wrong. The doctor should be punished. The family member should be punished. Sex education should be taught in the schools and the medical certificate should be produced by bride and bridegroom before the marriage to see whether they have HIV, AIDS and STD. Still in many schools and colleges, still in our society, it's considered to be a taboo to teach sex or speak sex openly. Every school from the class 1, sex education should be taught. We can see the child abuse. We can see the teenage girls and boys going in a wrong direction. They are eager to know what is sex. So it should be taught in schools and colleges. So before marriage, the bride sees how much the bridegroom is earning, what is the property of the bridegroom, how much the bride has studied, what is the income she is earning. But nobody says whether they are physically fit to deliver a child, whether the man is physically fit, whether the woman is physically fit, whether they have HIV, whether they have AIDS, whether they have kidney problem, whether they have liver problem, whether they have a heart problem. So medical certificate should be made a must in each and every marriage. And the marriage halls and temples and churches and mosques, they should have a compulsory need of the girl and the boy bringing the medical certificate showing that they are not affected by any disease. A country like India should adopt the policy of Europe and American countries to bring a socially harmonious and a healthy married life to Indians. Healthy married life based on good health. Not based on money, not based on status, not based on power. A healthy married life, that is the norm should we adopt, we should adopt here in India. Then with a great social freedom results in men and women moving freely, and this resulted in creating a lot of unwed mothers. Earlier society was biased on females. Now equal opportunity is given in property. Equal opportunity is given in education. Bank loans are provided. Reservation for jobs, females, is provided by the government. Government is giving hundreds of welfare measures for females. So this social status created a lot of unwed mothers. So here, abortions help them from unnecessary humiliations and responsibilities. Unnecessary humiliations are avoided. Unnecessary responsibilities are avoided. So, நண்பர்களே, உங்களுடைய கூட்டு விவாத புஸ்தகம் குரூப் டிஸ்கஷன் புக் 217-19 எடுத்துக்கொள்ளுங்கள். இங்கே லீகலைசேஷன் ஆஃப் அபார்ஷன் இந்தியா இஸ் ஜஸ்டிஃபைட். அப்போ கருத்து குடும்ப கட்டுப்பாடு அல்லது அபார்ஷன் பண்ணுவது சட்டப்பூர்வமாக ஏற்றுக்கொள்ளப்படுகிறதா இல்லையா, இதுதான் தலைப்பு. இந்தியா முழுக்க இந்த குடும்ப கட்டுப்பாடு, இந்தியா முழுக்க குடும்ப கட்டுப்பாடு நடைபெற்றுக் கொண்டிருக்கிறது. அரசாங்கம் இதற்கு ஊக்குவிக்கிறது, அரசாங்கம் பணம் பரிசுகளை கொடுக்கிறது. ஜனத்தொகையை, இந்திய ஜனத்தொகையை குறைக்க வேண்டும் என்பவர்கள் இந்த அபாஷன் சட்ட ரீதியாக ஆக்கப்பட வேண்டும், சுதந்திரம் வழங்க வேண்டும் என்பதற்காக அவர்கள் வரவேற்பார்கள். இந்தியா சரியான திசையை நோக்கித்தான் சென்று கொண்டிருக்கிறது என்று சொல்வார்கள். அபாஷன் என்பது ஆங்கிலத்திலே அபாஷன் என்று தமிழில் என்ன சொல்வீங்க? கருத்தடை என்பது ஒரு டெலிகேட் சப்ஜெக்ட் என்றால் என்ன? ஒரு நுண்ணிய விஷயம், மனதிலே நுண்ணிய விஷயம். அது மாரல் என்றால் என்ன? அவர்களுடைய ஒழுக்கம், எமோஷனல் உணர்வு. சென்டிமெண்டல் என்றால் என்ன? சென்டிமெண்டல் உணர்வு பூர்வமான ஒரு 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 பாதிப்பை சமுதாயத்திற்கு குடிக்கிறது. ஆனோ ஒரு பெண் ஒரு கருத்தனை செய்யக்கொள்ளலாம், ஒரு சில நேரங்களில் அவள் உடம்பு ரொம்ப ரொம்ப வீக்காக இருக்கும் பொழுது குழந்தை பெற்றுக்கொண்டால் அவள் உயிர் போய்விடும் என்கிற நிலையிலே, அந்த நிலையிலே அபாஷன் செய்து கொள்ளலாம். அபாஷன் என்பது பல குடும்பத்திற்கு வரப்பிரசாதமாக வந்துவிட்டது. இன்னொன்று இந்த அபாஷனுக்கு எதிராக சொல்ல வேண்டுமென்றால், இந்தியா ஒரு வளமான நாடு, ஜனத்தொகை அதிகமாக இருக்கிற காரணத்தினாலே அபாஷன் செய்து கொள்ளலாம் என்பது தவறு. இந்தியா சைனாவை போன்றோ இல்லை ஆஸ்திரேலியாவை போன்றோ அங்கே 10% 20% நிலங்கள் தான் உபயோகப்படுத்தப்படுகிறது. இந்தியாவிலே காஷ்மீரிலிருந்து கன்னியாகுமரி வரைக்கும் நிலங்கள் வளமாக இருக்கிறது. ஸோ இந்தியாவினுடைய வளத்திற்கும் இந்தியாவினுடைய ஜனத்தொகைக்கும் அபாஷனுக்கும் எந்த சம்பந்தமும் இல்லை. அடுத்ததாக, அபாஷன் கருத்தடை அல்லது சிசு கொலை, வயிற்றிலே இருக்கும்போது சிசு கொலை செய்வது என்பது ஒரு பெண் தனக்கு பிறக்கக்கூடிய குழந்தை பெண்ணாக இருந்தால் சிசு கொலை செய்து விடுகிறார் வயிற்றிலே, அது தவறு. அப்படி அதற்கு ஊக்குவிக்கக்கூடிய அந்த மருத்துவர்கள் தண்டிக்கப்பட வேண்டும், அவருடைய பெற்றோர்கள் தண்டிக்கப்பட வேண்டும். ஸோ ஆனா பெண்ணா என்பதை கண்டுபிடிப்பதற்கு குழந்தை 3 மாதம் வயதில் இருக்கும்போது தான் கண்டுபிடிக்க முடியும். அப்பொழுது அதற்கப்புறம் அவாஷன் செய்து கொள்வதனால் அந்த பெண்ணினுடைய உடல் மிகவும் குன்றி விடுகிறது. இந்த அபாஷன் செய்வதன் மூலமாக ஒரு பெண்ணுடைய வாழ்க்கை காலகட்டம் குறைந்து விடுகிறது. அநேக டூப்ளிகேட் டாக்டர்ஸ், போலி மருத்துவர்கள் கிராமங்களிலே அதிகமாக இருக்கிறார்கள். அவர்களும் இந்த பெண்களுடன் வாழ்க்கையுடன் விளையாடி கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள். இந்த அபாஷன் குறைப்பதற்காக பல குடும்ப கட்டுப்பாடு முறைகள், கான்ட்ராசெப்டிவ் மெசர்ஸ், இந்த பிரெக்னன்சி என்று சொல்லக்கூடிய பிரெக்னென்ட் ஆகாமல் இருப்பதற்காக கொடுக்கப்பட்டிருக்கிறது. அநேக கிராமங்களிலே டீனேஜ் பெண்கள் இறந்து விடுகிறார்கள் இந்த அபாஷன் செய்யும் பொழுது. அந்த டாக்டர்களுக்கு மற்றவர்கள் உயிரை எடுப்பதற்கு என்ற விதமான உரிமையும் கிடையாது. 7வது பாயிண்ட், குளோபலைசேஷன் என்றால் உலகமயமாக்குதல். ஒரு ஹுண்டாயும் சென்ட்ரோவும் ஒரு பிஎம்டபிள்யூவும் ஒரு ஐபிஎம்மும் நிறைய சர்வதேச நிறுவனங்கள் இந்தியாவுக்கு வந்திருக்கிறது. ஆணும் பெண்ணும் அங்கே சரிசமமாக வேலை செய்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள். அவர்களுடைய மேற்கத்திய கலாச்சாரம் இந்தியாவுக்கு வந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறது. அவர்கள் ஒன்றாக வாழ்கிறார்கள், திருமணம் செய்யாமல் வாழ்கிறார்கள். குழந்தை சில சமயம் கர்ப்பம் உருவாகிறது, அதை நீக்குகிறார்கள். என்னதான் மேற்கத்திய கலாச்சாரத்திலே வாழ்ந்தாலும் இது ஒரு அவமானமாக கருதப்படுகிறது. ஸோ இங்கே அபாஷன் பெரும் உதவியாக இருக்கிறது. நாம் நம்மளுடைய முன்னோர்களைப் போல வாழ வேண்டும். 8வது பாயிண்ட், ராஜாக்கள் ராணிகள் அந்த காலத்திலே வாழ்ந்தார்கள், இயற்கையுடன் ஒன்றி வாழ்ந்தார்கள் நம் முன்னோர்கள். எத்தனை குழந்தைகள் வேண்டுமென்றாலும் பெற்றுக்கொள்ளலாம் என்கிற ஒரு நிலை. அப்படியாக இந்தியாவிலும் அப்படி வாழ வேண்டும், அப்படி என்று டாபிக்கு எதிராக போகிறது. இந்த அபாஷன் யாருக்கு வேணும்? திருமணமாகாத பெண்களுக்கு மட்டும் செய்து கொள்ளலாம் என்ற உரிமையை வழங்க வேண்டும். ஒவ்வொரு பள்ளியிலும், ஒவ்வொரு கல்லூரியிலும் இந்த பாலியல் என்று சொல்லக்கூடிய செக்ஸ் எஜுகேஷன் சொல்லித்தரப்பட வேண்டும். திருமணத்திற்கு முன் ஒரு பெண் வருங்கால கணவன் என்ன சம்பாதிக்கிறான், என்ன சொத்து இருக்கிறது என்று பார்ப்பதை விட இந்த ஆணும் பெண்ணும், மணமகனும் மணமகளும் அவர்களுக்கு உடல் ரீதியாக நோய்கள் இருக்கிறதா, செக்ஸ் நோய்கள் இருக்கிறதா என்று மருத்துவ சான்றிதழ் பெறப்பட்டு அந்த திருமணத்தின் பொழுது ஒரு ஆண் பெண்ணிடமும், பெண் ஆணிடமும், ஆண் வீட்டார் பெண்ணிடம், பெண் வீட்டாரிடமும், பெண் வீட்டார் ஆணிடம், ஆண் வீட்டாரிடமும் அந்த மருத்துவ சான்றிதழை பெற்ற பின்தான் அவர்கள் திருமணம் செய்து கொள்ள வேண்டும். இதை சட்டப்பூர்வமாக ஆக்க வேண்டும். திருமணத்திற்கு கண்டிப்பாக காண்பிக்க வேண்டியது மருத்துவ ரீதியாக ஆணுக்கும் பெண்ணுக்கும் நோயில்லை, ஆண் உடல் ரீதியாக நன்றாக இருக்கிறான், பெண் உடல் ரீதியாக நன்றாக இருக்கிறார், கிட்னி லிவர் என்று எந்த விதமான பிரச்சனையும் இல்லை என்று பொழுது மட்டுமே அந்த திருமணத்திற்கு அரசாங்கம் சம்மதம் கொடுக்க வேண்டும். ஸோ இது ஒரு அரசாங்க ஆணையாக ஏற்படுத்தப்பட வேண்டும். அடுத்ததாக சோசியல் ஃப்ரீடம் என்று சொல்லக்கூடிய சமுதாய சுதந்திரம் இந்தியாவிலே வந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறது. பெண்களுக்கு சம உரிமை சொத்துக்களில், பெண்களில் கல்விக்கு சம உரிமை, வேலை வாய்ப்புகளில் அதிக உரிமை, அரசியலிலே 33 ரிசர்வேஷன் என்று சொல்லக்கூடிய சிவில் பாடி எலெக்ஷன்ஸ், உள்ளாட்சி மன்ற தேர்தலிலே 33% இடஒதுக்கீடு, இவைகளெல்லாம் பெண்களுக்கு அதிக உரிமைகள் வழங்கியிருக்கிற காரணத்தினாலே நிறைய பெண்கள் அன்வெட் மதர்ஸ் என்று சொல்லக்கூடிய திருமணம் ஆகாமலே கர்ப்பம் அடைந்து விடுகிறார்கள். ஸோ இங்கே அபாஷன் ஒரு நல்லது. அவர்களுக்கு அவமானத்திலிருந்து, அவர்களுக்கு ஒரு விதிவிலக்காகவும், அவமானத்திலிருந்து மேலும் அவர்களுக்கு பொறுப்புகள் பலவும் கொடுக்கப்படுகிறது. ஸோ இதன் மூலமாக இப்போ நான் உங்களுக்கு குரூப் டிஸ்கஷனில் விட்டு விடுகிறேன், கூட்டு விவாதம். ஸோ ஈச் ஒன் ஆஃப் யூ கேன் சே யோர் பாயிண்ட்ஸ். எஸ், ஸ்டார்ட் த டாபிக். மை டியர் ஃப்ரெண்ட், வாட்ஸ் யோர் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வாட்ஸ் யோர் வியூ ஆன் லீகலைசேஷன் ஆஃப் அபார்ஷன்ஸ்?
பிஃபோர் we legally accept abortion in India, we have to understand our Indian society, let us say our social background. Our society is a male dominated society where women were considered as second class citizens. Women are forced to abort the female infanticide, let us say only female children. We hardly hear that they abort male children, they abort nothing. Always we hear it is because a female child, the parents or the mother tended to abort the female children. Then second thing, we see it's because of this abortion, duplicate doctors, money-minded doctors, the unwedded mothers, you know, they rush to these doctors telling that it is our social status. We have to safeguard our social status in town or village. For that, they try any doctor, whether she, the doctor is a real man, a real educator, he has that human concern, they don't bother about. Then later they will have so many problems regarding the health. The another thing, we have a false idea. For example, if we are not allowing abortion in India, then how to control the population in India? I think there is no connection between this controlling the population or abortion. It has no valid reason. There is no truth in it. For the medical ground, I accept. For the medical ground, when a pregnant woman gives birth to child, then there is a problem to safeguard the mother or the child. The doctor has to decide. Then, and we also understand mercy killing also. In that sense, we can allow. But every rule has its own exceptions. So, it's better we don't avoid abortion. But at the same time, because of this medical reasons, we can have this abortion as an exception. But what I think about this abortion, no? Proper sex education, family planning program, and the responsibility of the society. If we concentrate on these points, and if we try to exercise this in our society, there is no need for abortion. Thank you.
Very good. Some of the valid points of what he has told is health on health grounds, and second, he is told we can hear only the female abortions, it's not the male abortions, male child abortions. And third, he has told about the sex education which should be taught in the schools and colleges. That's what he has told. Okay, now, madam, what's your point of view? What do you think about this topic?
Abortion is essential for this world. Without abortion, many women suffered a lot. So, abortion, there we have two merit and advantages, and disadvantages are there. Disadvantages means when one woman feel so strong, not healthy, if go for abortion means she will die. And abortion leads to reduce her lifespan also. So shouldn't do like that. Abortion is allowed only for unwed mothers. Like that we can allowed it. And sex education is improper. So many problems are coming here. So we should learn from our schooling days also, from childhood on, so they can taught like that. Then they will go for correct way. So abortion is very much essential.
Okay. Now, what is your point of view, madam? What do you think about this? What you have told is something very valid point. It's not the male who is affected physically. It is the females who are affected. Her lifespan reduces. Unwed mothers can be given treatment because it's a It's a responsibility, a lifelong responsibility for the female. Where the male doesn't be bothered, he is not bothered, the father is not bothered, or the man who is not bothered. It's the only the mother who has to take care of the child till her lifetime. So the responsibilities are given on the child, forced on the female at the young age. So she has to take care. This is a wonderful point. Yes, madam.
On this point, first I want to say that why we are going to abort a child? What is the cause behind that? If it is that they are aborting because of that a female child, then it is very illegal. If because of other reason they are aborting, maybe child is not developed properly, and it can cause harm or death to mother also, to child also, in that condition it should be legal. But on the base of this girl and male and female child, we doctor should not have this right to find out that that sex identification should not be allowed. First of all that, because lot of people they are aborting because of that reason only, that is a female child, it cause harm to that child also and mother also, because nobody other suffers in the family, only the mother. Generally she does not want to abort her child, female child, because mother have the similar feeling for her male or female child. But other people, they want a male child only to run their family. And
so wonderful point she has told. What she has told is the mother doesn't show partiality whether the child which she is carrying in the stomach is it a boy or a girl. She has the true and unbiased feeling for whether it is a boy or a girl. This one point, valid point she has told. Yes, ma'am. Okay, now next, what's your point, sir, regarding abortions, and is it legalized in religion wise? In Christianity it is not accepted, in Islam it is not accepted, in Hinduism it is not accepted, Jainism, Judaism, no, it's all God's gift, that's what they say. But the economical burden of carrying the child, bringing up the child, breeding the child.
Abortion is a one of the important things which you have to speak about. That there is two phases of if you are doing abortion, there is two phases are there. One is good or bad. The good things are if a mother carrying a baby with his small ear, that can cause his death, and also it leads to the entire life of the family. So such kind of a thing, such kind of a situation, in the, we should do the abortion. That is a social thing. We can't able to avoid that. In our country, there are a lot of uneducated peoples are there, and a lot of child marriages happening in nowadays. So in such condition, we can't able to avoid the abortion with a low age mother and low birth babies. So and also a lot of the social calamities like rape and sexual abuses are happening. So such condition, we should respect the we should allow the abortion to do and to protect the lady from that situation. So in that condition, we should always do the abortion as legally. And the other thing is there is lot of demerits and are there also, because people are abusing the law of abortion, and our government has given a strict law regarding abortion, like the people who are not willing to give birth on a female child. So that things they are doing abortion in our in our country. So that's why the government give a order to ban the sexual determination, and that leads to aborting a female lady in our country. So that should be avoided, and strict law and implementation should be there. Then only that problem has to be solved. So
wonderful point he has told. Child abuse, that is the female child getting abused. But one thing, mind you, everybody should know that the child is abused by its own known members, family members, relations. It may be uncle, it may be a cousin, it may be a father, it may be a brother, it may be grandfather. It is happening, it is uncle. So let us not hide the fact. 90% of abuses are done to the females by their own family and relations. So to avoid the humiliation of carrying a child where that girl doesn't have on her part, there wasn't any mistake for that, it should be done. It is a good thing, it is a boon for the girl. Apart from that, a child, with or without knowing, at the young age, she falls a prey to the, you know, the worldly, whatever the opposite sex says, and somehow she becomes pregnant, and later she regrets, and for that, abortion is a boon. That's what he says. Good, valid point, sir. What's your point regarding these abortions, and what?
So
what
everybody talk about the good thing of abortion. I would like to tell you about the bad thing. Nowadays, ladies are engaging pimps, called as pimps. It's a prostitution. It's widespread in India. It's a very disadvantage. Even though we are going for the globalization, we are following the Western culture here. A lot of popes are emerging here. So the abortion, the lady will affair with the unknown X or Y, Z, that will cause more abortion. Instead of the unborn child, the lady carrying, woman carrying with the unborn child, or the ungrown development. So that's thing, the abortion could be good, but the bad thing is that ladies suffer with